This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Story: The House with the Mezzanine, a Painter's Story. Topic 1. It happened nigh on 7 years ago, when I was living in one of the districts of the J province, on the estate of Bila Karav, a landowner, a young man who used to get up early, dress himself in a long overcoat, drink beer in the evenings, and all the while complained to me that he could nowhere find anyone in sympathy with his ideas. He lived in a little house in the orchard, and I lived in the old manor house, in a huge pillared hall where there was no furniture except a large divan on which I slept, and a table at which I used to play patience. Even in calm weather there was always a moaning in the chimney, and in a storm the whole house would rock and seem as though it must split, and it was quite terrifying, especially at night, when all the 10 great windows were suddenly lit up by a flash of lightning. Doomed by fate to permanent idleness, I did positively nothing. For hours together I would sit and look through the windows at the sky, the birds, the trees, and read my letters over and over again, and then for hours together I would sleep. Sometimes I would go out and wander aimlessly until evening. Once on my way home, I came unexpectedly on a strange farmhouse. The sun was already setting, and the lengthening shadows were thrown over the ripening corn. Two rows of closely planted tall fir trees stood like two thick walls, forming a somber, magnificent avenue. I climbed the fence and walked up the avenue, slipping on the fir needles which lay 2 inches thick on the ground. It was still dark, and only here and there in the tops of the trees shimmered a bright gold light, casting the colors of the rainbow on a spider's web. The smell of the firs was almost suffocating. Then I turned into an avenue of limes. And here too were desolation and decay. The dead leaves rustled mournfully beneath my feet, and there were lurking shadows among the trees. To the right, in an old orchard, a goldhammer sang a faint, reluctant song, and he too must have been old. The lime trees soon came to an end, and I came to a white house with a terrace and a mezzanine, and suddenly a vista opened upon a farmyard, with a pond and a bathing shed, and a row of green willows, with a village beyond, and above it stood a tall, slender belfry, on which glowed a cross catching the light of the setting sun. For a moment I was possessed with a sense of enchantment, intimate, particular, as though I had seen the scene before in my childhood. By the white stone gate surmounted with stone lions, which led from the yard into the field, stood two girls. One of them, the elder, thin, pale, very handsome, with masses of chestnut hair and a little stubborn mouth, looked rather prim, and scarcely glanced at me. The other, who was quite young, 17 or 18, no more, also thin and pale, with a big mouth and big eyes, looked at me in surprise as I passed, said something in English and looked confused, and it seemed to me that I had always known their dear faces. And I returned home feeling as though I had awoke from a pleasant dream. Soon after that, one afternoon, when Bila Karav and I were walking near the house, suddenly there came into the yard a spring carriage in which sat one of the two girls, the elder. She had come to ask for subscriptions to a fund for those who had suffered in a recent fire. Without looking at us, she told us very seriously how many houses had been burned down in Sianov, how many men, women, and children had been left without shelter, and what had been done by the committee of which she was a member. She gave us the list for us to write our names, put it away, and began to say goodbye. "You have completely forgotten us, Peter Petrovich," she said to Bila Karav as she gave him her hand. "Come and see us, and if Mr. N," she said my name, "would like to see how the admirers of his talent live and would care to come and see us, then Mother and I—"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.